Glenn, do you hear me well?
Yes, we do indeed, Fabian. How are you?
Very well, very well.
Good.
I said that thank you for the presentation, and I'm glad to for giving me the opportunity to share my experience that the last 3 years in more than 1,000 patients with this device. Can I start with the presentation?
Absolutely, yes, please.
Okay. First, I need to mention that I'm a KOL of Lutronic. I receive fee for this conference, and all the BNA photos are patient treated by me. I decided to divide this presentation in three parts: tattoo removal, pigmental lesion, and skin improvements. To remind you that most of laser devices that you know work in milliseconds or microseconds. That's why they create a photothermal effect. Really different between the PCT laser, who works in nanoseconds or picoseconds and generate a photomechanical effect. But not all the QuickSwitch lasers act in the same way. You need to know that nanosecond devices still transfer heat to the surrounding tissues. That's why, in some cases, we can get side effects. Opposite to the photomechanical effect, close to 100% of photomechanical effect of the picosecond devices. I love this drawing to show you that any kind of laser with a pulse width of 1 picosecond or close to it have a close to 100% of photomechanical effects. Instead of the laser to go close to the milliseconds, are close to a complete photothermal effect. In the middle, we have a lot of different kind of lasers. It's important to mention that it's not the same if you can send 1.2 joules in a pulse width of 5 nanoseconds, because in this case, the peak of power is only 240 megawatts. Less or similar joules, but if you can send in less than a nanosecond, in 450 picosecond, you can obtain a peak of power of 1.8 gigawatts. And it's important to mention that bigger power in less part of time, we can obtain more particle disruption. And this allows our macrophages to eat it well and make it easier the work to get away from the skin, not only pigmental lesion as particles of ink at the same time. I start with the Pico Plus using in tattoo removal, majority of my experience. I really believe in that tattoos no longer have to last forever. We all have the right to repaint, like Transformers. And I really believe in these two phrases. We are able to say that a quarter of people around the world have at least one tattoo. That's a lot of statistics to show us. And we are able to say too that a quarter of them are going to regret it and will look for a solution. And all that potential patients. Only in 2015, ASAPS show us that in a year, there was an increase of the close to 100% in the appointment looking for tattoo removal only in the USA. There are different motivation to raise or improve a tattoo. For example, visible area required by job, for example, admission to army, to police, or any security force. Change of significant of other, when you change your couple, your new one doesn't know any kind of relation with the previous one, and ask you to remove this number or name or any figure of the previous couple. High meaning of the tattoo. If you have a gang tattoo, for example, you are really look for removal as faster as you can do it. Improve part of the tattoo. I want to show a case that the patient only want to remove a part of the tattoo, not all. In some cases, the patient asks to reduce the tone to make it easier the work to the tattoo artist. In other cases, they simply bored. I want to show you a case of allergic reaction to pigment. And finally, we getting older, we change our mindsets. This is my complete experience from 2006 until today. I treated more than 1,312 patients, and at my actual period of PICO, I treated more than 584 patients. If I have an average of 6 sessions in every patient with a rate of 1 to 12 sessions, give us approximate figure than more than 3,500 treatments only in 3 years and only with this device. I made my own survey with my patient in 757 patients who came to my office looking for tattoo removal from August to 2017 to 2020. Majority of them were women with an average of 30 years old, close to the half with a high degree of education. The most common color are black in 60% of them. The second color was the multicolor is fashion at this day. The third part of the tattoo are on the upper limbs, arm for arm, wrist and hands. And when we ask for the reason to removal, more than the half say that this is dissatisfied with how it was made or the evolution over time because loss of definition. The second cause was job, and the third one was couple change in 14% of the cases. The vast majority regret the tattoo really soon, in the first year, 10% of them, and more than the half in the first 5 years. 5% of them only saw to get improve of the tattoo, not for a complete removal. And as I became a referral center for tattoo removal, 20% of my patients look me with the previously undergone laser, and in some cases, my own colleague sent me the patient with any kind of problem. As I said, there's allergic reaction to pigment, always by red tongue, because it was made by mercury sulfide and can cause on my patient scald, scars, or included keloids. This is the patient with this reaction. As you can see, at the moment when I finish the treatment and I remove all the red tone, and when I ask to the patient return for the control, he put these new tones in the same area, and this is possible. There are some difficult depending on location of the tattoo. More thinner and more close to the lymph node, more easier. That's why face and neck are the easier areas and more difficult on shoulder, lower back, and extremities. And there's another difficult depending on tattoo ink characteristics. Are easier, black and red, the shallow ones, low density. Carbon-based ink are classical for amateur tattoo and the older ones. But it's really more difficult in light blue and green are the most difficult colors. Deeper ink, high density, inorganic ink, iron and titanium are classical for professional tattoo and the Western ones. How does the PICO second laser succeed in erasing tattoo? By the photoacoustic reaction. I love to give this exam because all of us were playing with the Pac-Man. The problem of this Pac-Man, our macrophages is really little in compare with the great phantom. Well, we need to help him. We apply the picosecond domain and we shut it down in really little phantom and make it easier to work to our macrophages to digest and take away. He's going to take away by the lymph system and go directly to the lymph node. And why we need four different wavelengths, like the wavelength that this device have. Because majority of the picosecond have only two wavelengths. That's why if we think about the color of the rainbow, it can be successful in only a part of them, on the red tone, for example, in the black too. But if I have four different wavelengths, I can be successful in all the color of the rainbow and in the black too. For example, in this mosquito tattoo with five different kind of color, are really difficult if I didn't have three different kind of wavelengths. But not all the picosecond devices are the same. I take a complete year of my life study which one is the best to buy, and I decided for this one because I have four wavelengths, I have a great peak of power in a less part of time. And if I add four wavelengths, maximum power, maximum speed, for sure I can obtain less particles disruption, and is get it again easier the world to our macrophages to eat it and take away. Here I am working on the patient. I perform the treatment every 30 to 60 days. The rate or the average, sorry, for the professional tattoo are 8 sessions. The average for amateur tattoo are 4 sessions. The treatment is painful. I need to use cold gel pad, cold air, anesthetic cream, and in some cases, anesthetic by injection. And you can choose between the 4 wavelengths depending on the color of the tattoo. Always increase energy little by little. I try to avoid any kind of side effects. My endpoints are redness or frosting, and I always, in a post-treatment, ask for cover with Vaseline. My result, I start saying that my best result, my best BNA photo needs a lot of time. This is the classical sequence. Previously, 1 month, 2 months, 3rd month, and when I ask to the patient 6 months after the last treatment to send me a photo to be sure the quality of the skin, and this is it without any kind of particle of ink. In some cases, it's more easier and much faster. This patient have this traumatic tattoo by a car accident, and in only one session, I can be successful. Or in this case, always cosmetic tattoo, simulate hair in only 2 sessions when the patient regrets, we can be successful and erase all the shadow of the hair. Another cosmetic tattoo in the ash brown, in 3 sessions, we can be successful and erase all the ink in this area. Some cases are more difficult. A cosmetic tattoo take me 7 sessions, but it was successful too. And in some cases, I mentioned that menu à la carte. But why? Because the patient can ask me to remove part of the tattoo, not all. She loved these 3 stars and she wants to erase the rest inside the stars, and I can be successful and the patient are really happy with the result. Another case, complete removal on the feet, 4 sessions. Another case, complete removal on the finger, 6 sessions. Complete removal on the forearm, 6 sessions. Complete removal on the neck, 6 sessions. Another complete removal on the forearm, 7 sessions. Another complete removal, take me a little more, 11 sessions in the arm. Really difficult area, bikini line, 7 sessions to remove all the color of this tattoo. A really difficult area, the back, and in 7 sessions I was successful. Another good result, 9 sessions. A really, really difficult tattoo because cover all the forearm with a lot of ink and it wasn't ink. This is the moment I decide to finish the treatment with these wellnesses, with this PIH. And at the moment I asked to the patient to return for a control 6 months later. And as you can see, there isn't any kind of color of ink. Really difficult tattoo, 7 different kind of colors in the middle of the treatment. When we finish and we can leave hyperpigmentation and leucoderma, and the way I ask for an actual photo, I be sure to month per month, year per year, the patient are going to return the normal color of the skin. Another great difficult tattoo, Western one, great amount of ink and different kind of tone of color, and the way I can fix it, She's still in progress. For sure, I can reduce more color, maybe in 3 or 4 more sessions. Another really difficult tattoo, 7 kind of different tone of colors. This is the last session. As you can see, there is still residual color over there and here. And I asked for a control for this presentation. And this is the actual situation with this residual color over there, here, and here, but the rest is only PIH. That's why it's only a matter of time to have great results. Again, our mosquito tattoo and the actual situation, we have residual color of the light blue, the really most difficult color with green, and we are still in progress. As I mentioned, I became a specialized center for tattoo removal. Some colleague sent me the problem. This is a patient with 6 sessions with nanosecond laser. This is the residual color at the middle of my treatment. And after 9 sessions, this is my result. Another patient became from another center, only 2 sessions, and they didn't have any improve in light colors. And this is the way I leave the quality of the skin in this area after 12 sessions. Another patient came to me for another center. The previous tattoo were green and black. Well, I leave this leucoderma and hypopigmentation, and it's only a matter of time to return to the normal color. If I can wait, for example, 6 months, for sure I can obtain a better photo. I put 0 session because this is a patient of mine, and I decide to wait. She came 3 months before I can get the Pico Plus, and I said, wait for the best one. By the Pico, I can be sure to remove not only black and green too. This is the result I put in progress because I still wait for the final photo. As I said, you, some patients look only for the reduce of the tone to give the possibility to the tattoo artist to make this really love and good tattoo in the same area. As I told you, my best result need a lot of time, but especially to resolve the transitory PIH. If you can see here, there isn't any amount of ink in this area, but we can see the phantom of the tattoo. It takes 6 months, a year at least to lose this phantom. Just, it's another case in 7 sessions, and you can see the phantom of the tattoo. And I show you that this tattoo like a great result. And this is the moment when I finished the treatment and I said, it's a matter of time, you need to wait at least a year. My patient agreed with that. This is the patient after a year with a complete loss of the phantom. Another case, previously, when I finished the treatment and when I asked for a new photo, after a year, and this is the quality of the skin in the same area. There are some side effects. We need to say that to the patient. If you have a cosmetic tattoo with black tones, be careful because it was made by iron, in some cases turned to red. The patient loved this new tone, but take care about the white one because it was made by titanium and can change to black or green. And it's really headache. It's a great problem. It takes me no less than 20 sessions to remove it. Or just in this case, the patients, I really love the treatment, are really happy with me, but I can still see a skin texture change in the area. Maybe in a year, I can show you a better result, but actually you can see a phantom of the tattoo. Or just in this case, I leave dots or points of leucoderma, and I need to wait maybe a year to be sure is going to disappear. These are my actual parameters. I always go step by step. In 1064, I start in 1 joule and rising. In 532, I start in 0.6 and rising. And these are my parameters for 595 and 660, the dialyzers to have this device. When I mentioned the treatment for pigmental lesion, I always start to say that, remember that we try benign pigmental lesion, no others. When we ask for shallow ones like lentigo, Frigglex, and keratosis, and the deep ones like melasma, PIH, post-burn, nevus, abnorm, otanevus, or café au lait. Remember too that the shallow ones are really easy to remove. Any kind of laser can do it. We can obtain temporary or permanent elimination depending on the lesions. Their deep dermal lesions are really difficult to remove. Only few lasers can do it. Please look only for Q-switch laser to avoid PIH or paradoxical effects. And we always obtain clearing. Why? Because remember, we can eliminate melanosomes, not melanocytes. It's a matter of time, in some cases, the pigmental lesion can reappear. And how can I avoid the PIH in deep dermal benign pigmental lesion laser treatment? By this, the concept of the dendritectomy. We apply the laser, look for the melanin inside the melanosome, inside the dendrites. As the picosecond domain doesn't transfer heat to surrounding tissue, we are sure to destroy this part of the cell, but leave intact the core of the cell. That's why we can avoid the PIH. When we treat melasma, remember that is not only surface, on the surface, at in the deeper part of the skin too. That's why we need to use the concept of the laser toning. We use the 1064 and we apply the laser several times, several paths over the skin with really low joules, close to 1 joule, to be sure to destroy the pigmental lesions with minimal thermal damage with subcellular selective phototermolysis. It means I can destroy the melanite inside the dendrites, but without any injuries to the core of the cell. That's why I can avoid the PIH. This is my end point when I try a patient with melasma over there in the chin. I look only for that, no frosting, no bleeding, no petechia, nothing like that, only wetnesses. And this is the result. And oh, why I take all this care to avoid the thermal transfer? Because I need to avoid the hidden enemy of laser treatment, the PIH. I'm going to show you some results. For example, in this male, dark circles around the periorbital area, I take the color of the photo to measure perfectly the way I can reduce this quantity of pigment in the same area, around the periorbital area. Or it's really easy to remove these lentigos in the nasal, malar, and temporal area. When we try to fix it or get improved in the melasma, remember that we can be successful to reduce the amount of pigment, not to take it all. Look here, I'm going to take the color of the photo to measure the reduction of the color in the profile too. And this is a successful treatment. Like in this case, in the upper lips, here it is. You can see a little quantity of pigment, but for sure I can reduce a lot, like the previous photo of the patients. When I add lentigo and melasma in this profile, my result is only 2 sessions, the other profile only 2 sessions. This really great result in otanevus take me 14 sessions, but it's amazing that the patient not only are really happy about the decrease of the color of the Otanebus. They say me they are really happy with the improving the quality in the skin after 14 sessions around the periorbital area. Or just in this another case of Otanebus, she's still in progress, only four sessions, but I use this system, the Vectra system, to measure the brown points evaluation. And you can see over there the reduction, and over there the reduction of the brown points. This mean is making disappear these pigmental lesions. Again, a close view before and after four sessions to show how can I make it disappear all these brown points. Another area that the patient look for get improved is in the armpits, or is fashion at this day. This means genital whitening, not only on the buttock, or in the bikini line too. These are my usual parameters for deep lesions in 1064, the laser beam, and my usual Joules. For Otanebi, I need to be a little more aggressive, and for the shallow one, I need to be less aggressive, as you can see here in these slides. Even so, was made by a spectral device, a nanosecond device. I put this slides because for sure, a nano and picosecond are the exclusive indication for hemosiderosis. Don't try to use any other kind of laser. Could switch it, and picosecond especially is the best indication for this problem. Well, I reached for the last session of my presentation, the skin improvement. My patient asked me for a skin quality improvement on their face during the appointment. Well, I have this logical doubt. I have four different kind of laser, ablative and non-ablative laser. Well, I need to measure to my patient that if he agree with the scalp, bleeding, swelling, and to stay a complete week covered at home, well, maybe she's a patient who can ask for an ablative laser. If she tell me that she doesn't agree with all that circumstances that I mentioned, well, I choose between Hollywood pill or LIOB, laser-induced optical breakdown. When to remind you that ablative laser on my hand, I obtain best result only a few sessions, always by pain, and it takes me a long post-treatment recovery time, more than a week, and usually associated by PIH. Not ablative laser, on my hand, I obtain less result, more session, less or without pain. The post-treatment recovery time is less than 4 days and not a really PIH. And what is Hollywood pill? Like for us, nowadays, our patient knew about the treatment and asked me directly for that. We have greater demand for faster social and occupational reintegration. The patient called that laser branch. And to ask these two questions, what do you notice, but what the others don't notice? What this means? The patient wants an improvement in skin, but without any question or any mention or commentary from a partner that job, relationship or parents. The good patient for that are the one with great pigmentary expression, but without vascular expression. Remember that we work in picosecond, that's why it's impossible for us get an improve in telangiectasia or any kind of erythema or rosacea, only for pigmentary expressions. The best indication are the patient with large porous, and I need to mention that the redness on the skin that I leave during the treatment or after the treatment, it's only take 3 hours. And it's really easy to cover with makeup and return to the job or return to the social activities. As I mentioned, our patient knew about the treatment by media, Instagram, Facebook, and included have the US patent with the name of SpectraPill. I need to cover two steps before to apply the laser, to put the carbon solution over the skin, waiting 15 to 20 minutes to allow this carbon solution go inside the inner of the porous, and then apply the laser several times to be sure make this explosion not only in the surface, at the same time in the inner part of the porous to make it thicker, to make it closer. There's two good reasons to choose nanodomain instead of picodomain. Pico Plus is the only laser in the market to have two lasers inside the same device. I choose nano, why? Because as I told you, I prefer to transfer heat to surrounding tissue by nanodomain to stimulate the collagen cells and make it more thicker and more healthy the skin. And at the same time, if I use the nanodomain, I obtain less particle disruption of the carbon solution that was making fewer particles floating on the air. And in this way, I can have less optical, less damage, because this particle floating in the air can be in contact with the optical lens and damage it. Here I am doing the work. And as you can see, it's a patient with a large pores on the nose. And this is the way I fix it. And this is during the treatment. You can see how can I make the explosion of the carbon solution. With a close view to measure the size of the pores during the treatment and after the treatment. This patient with a great pigment expression, I'm going to take you a close view, and I'm going to take out the color of the photo to be sure, measure not only the reduction of the color, at the same time, the improve in the quality of the skin here in the malar area. Another patient with a great melasma in the central part of the face, and she's really happy not only by that, at the same time, by the skin improvement. In some cases, I decide to apply the two different kind of non-ablative laser. I start with the Hollywood pill, then I change to the dual focus dot to get improved not only the surface, at the inner part of the skin too, to the reticular and the papular dermis by the laser-induced optical breakdown. Look my patients in a close view to measure not only again the reduction of the color that is really easy to notice, but at the same time, the reduction of the size of the pores. In a profile, again, with a close view, and you can measure the improving the quality of the skin. But what is this? What is called rejuvenation or laser-induced optical breakdown? Well, it is this. We use a focus dot to create a photomechanical effect over the reticular papillary dermis, but without damaging the epidermis. This is really important. It's a non-ablative laser, and it's not mediated by chromophores. I need to choose the depth of the skin that I want to treat without any thermal transfer. That's why less or no PIH is really important to this kind of treatment. And usually take me 2 to 3 sessions. I create a waste in the laser beam, and I choose if I want to act at 3 millimeter, 1 millimeter, or on the surface. I create explosive expansion and vaporization that cause cavitation inside the dermis. Our body, our skin knew that it was hurt, and the way that I can fix it is fill it up with new collagen cells. That's why we make it thicker, we make it healthy, our skin. The hand device have three different kind of steps in to choose the depth that I want to add. This is my usual laser beam, and this is my usual power influence that I use over the skin. And here I am during the treatment, the patient with the acne sequel. The patient doesn't have any kind of anesthetic, and I want to leave part of this presentation of this video to show you in the way I leave wetness over the skin of my patient. Look at that, only that, no scalp, no bleeding. This is a patient after one day of laser-induced optical breakdown. As you can see, there is some petechias, wetness, but no scalp, no swelling, no bleeding. After the third day, this is the quality of the skin. And before and after the same patient, a close view, I'm going to take the color of the photo to give you the possibility to measure 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 kind of different little wrinkles, or only 2, just in this case. And in the profile, again, a close view. And again, I want to take the color of the photo to measure the reductions over the quantity of the little wrinkles around the periorbital area. This is the patient that I showed you during the treatment with the acne sequel. I performed 3 sessions. I'm going to show you a close view. And again, I'm going to take the color of the photo to give you the possibility to measure 1, 2, I don't know, maybe 10 acne scar or 20 acne scar over there, and less than 10. The other profile, the same patient, again, a close view. I want to take the color of the photo, and you can measure, I don't know, maybe 40 acne scar and less than 10. Some patients look only for get improved in the reduction of the size of the pores, and I choose this treatment if a patient allow me to have redness during 3 or 4 days, a close view. I want to take the color of the photo, and you can measure really easy the reduction, not only about the size of the pores, at the same time, I make it disappear all these pigmental lesions. This is my regular parameters for Hollywood pill, 1064, laser beam, my usual joules. And for laser-induced optical breakdown, I use the same parameters over the 3 steps. Of course, all my post-treatment indication, I ask for moistening, sunscreen. I use 2 or 3 different formulas or high inhibitor of melanization, like tranexamic acid, kochic acid, hydroquinone. I ask for a control on new treatment. Remember that this is a collagen stimulation that the patient need to return year per year if they want to get the same improve. My ideal rate for LIOB and Hollywood pill is 3 or 4 sessions. In conclusion, and close to the end of my presentations, deep pigmental lesion treatment are safer if they are treated with picosecond laser. It's for real, not paradoxical effect or not or less PIH. If you don't want any recovery time, you look for a skin improvement, please choose Hollywood pill. As I show you, it takes only 3 or 4 hours of wetness, no more than that. And at the same time, Hollywood pill can help you to reduce pigmentation and the size of the porous. But if you can allow 3 or 4 days with facial erythema, for me, the better choice is cold rejuvenation or LIOB. And at the same time, it's a good option, not only for improving the quality of the skin, at the same time to make a solution for acne sequel. In my experience, the application of picosecond pulse width cut regular tattoo removal session by 20 to 40%. In my nanosecond period, my rates are close to my average sessions are close to 10 to 12, and in my actual period of pico, my average is close to 6 to 8. If you try to remove light color tattoo, please, you need at least 3 or 4 wavelengths. And for me, it's essential the picosecond because it's the gold standard for this kind of colors of tattoo. And on my hands, it's weird or no color scar formation until today. I'm going to give you 2 pieces of advice. First, look for the most powerful, fastest, and versatility picosecond domain system available. As for that, as I told you, it takes me a complete year to be sure what is the best device to buy, and for sure, I think I buy the best. And the second advice, study the population of the place where you work or live. 1 in 4 inhabitants have at least 1 tattoo, and 20% of them will look for elimination or modification of it. That's why they are all potential patients. Well, nowadays, in pandemic and quarantine time, one look said it all. Well, thanks too much to all of you for your attention, and I just prepare for Q&A. Glenn, May Lee?
Yes, sir. Fantastic presentation, and I have to say there's a large selection of complimentary notes that have come in, both on the chat and in the Q&A. So thank you so very much, Fabian. Marvelous presentation.
Okay. Thank you.
Questions. Ah, the other thing is that we would like to see your face, if you don't mind. So, because I think you forgot to turn your camera on.
Oh, sorry for that.
There we are.
sorry.
No problem at all. Okay. Questions. Right. From your experience, have you seen any hypertrophic scars instead of only skin texture changes after tattoo removal in patients with a keloid history?
Yes, well, there are difficult areas like shoulder or the middle of the chest. I have plastic surgery, I know these difficult areas, but it's most common with my previous period with the nanoseconds. At this moment, 3 years with picosecond, I doesn't realize with any kind of scar at the moment.
Fantastic. Why is it with other brands, for example, the names that they've given here is Revlite or Fotona, you can't get the same results when using the Hollywood peel as you do with the Pico Plus?
Well, I don't know. I didn't use this kind of device. If they work with nanosecond, if they can send amount of power and they use the carbon solution over the skin, maybe it's possible.
Right. Sometimes when we're removing a tattoo, particularly red tattoo with 532, the color gets darker. Can you let this person know what's happening?
Yes, I mentioned that some kind of ink of the tattoo was made by iron. In some cases, they turned black to red and red to black because was in a oxidized form and in the desoxidized form. That's why you need to apply first, for example, 1064, and if it change to red, change to 532, and the opposite if they change to red to black. I show you the case of the patient with the tattoo around the areola and what has happened.
Right. How often do you need to replace the die rods in the gold toning and Ruvi Touch handpieces, and how easy is it to change them?
Well, I use the dye laser at the final of all of my treatment. I prefer to start to 532 because I can get a great amount of power. As you know, the dye laser have a filter inside. That's why we reduce the power that I can get. But it's very precisely for green and for light blue. That's why when I can reduce the amount of color, I look directly for the dye laser. That's why I always use in the final part of any kind of my tattoo removal sessions.
All righty, thank you very much. To avoid erythema, when you're doing your LIOB creation, could you apply that with lower joules than 1.2?
Yes, for sure, but I am plastic surgeon. I am an aggressive person. I love to have this kind of assault. I'm not afraid about that.
Yes, well, erythema, of course, is not a problem.
Erythema
is some. No, it's part of the wound healing.
Yes.
Okay. Can you make two or three passes using different depths of the LIOBs?
Yes, yeah, for sure. I love to give that opportunity and use it. I start always deeper to surface. I start in 3 millimeters, change to one, and finally with the surface.
Right. Very good. Do you use the picosecond laser to resolve the PIH that you occasionally find, or do you let it resolve by itself?
Well, very good question. Depends on the patient, depends on the color of the skin of my patient. If I have a Fitzpatrick 4 or 5, for sure, I need to help with my picosecond in 1064 in less joules to short the time of the recovery of the PIH. In some cases, as I mentioned, I use cream formula of high inhibitor of melanizations. I change 2 or 3 kind of different formula, and I always say it takes times, close a year. My best BNA photos are close after a year.
Because of the remodeling process, I would imagine.
Exactly. You need to weigh that.
All righty. Next question. Can we use the Hollywood peel technique with the nanosecond mode of Pico Plus?
Again, sorry, if I can use?
Can we use the Hollywood peel technique using the nanosecond mode of Pico Plus? 2 nanoseconds.
Yes. I show you that. I prefer to use nano and not Pico. I remember that because it's very important for 2 reasons. First, nanosecond is still transferred here to the surrounding tissues. And I want that. I want to transfer heat in the case of Hollywood peel, because I want to stimulate the creation of more collagen cells. And I can do it by the nanosecond domain. And on the other hand, it's really important, the Pico make great explosion with less particle of great disruption and less particle of the ink, and the fluid around the air and put in contact with the optical lens and damage it. I need to change 4 lenses about that. That's why I only use the picosecond in the nanosecond domain.
Very good. That's an excellent answer. For your tattoos, how long do you like to wait between the sessions?
Well, I write that every 30 to 60 days. I start every 30 days. Why? because I have a lot of color and the patients are really anxious. If I say, well, return in 3 months, the patient say me, doctor, are you funny with me? What do you think? What do you mean? The patient want to rest at the minute. They are regret and they want a great and soon solutions. That's why my first 3 or 4 sessions are always after 3 days, 30 days, sorry, every month. And when both of us, the patient and me, can show the reduction of the color, well, I wait 60 days.
Excellent. Here's a question right up my street. Can you apply Heal Light after PICO treatment to reduce the erythema?
Yeah, for sure, but I don't have this experience.
Well, you need to get one. Okay.
You try to sell that. You try to sell that to me.
Well, my baby. you mentioned that the light blue tattoos are amongst the most difficult to treat.
Yes,
do you have
sure.
a special order of wavelengths that you use when you're treating them?
Yes. I always start with 532 because I can get a lot of power when I reduce the amount, like the mosquito tattoo that I show you, that's really difficult tattoo. Then I have a limit with 532 because it's not the special wavelength for light blue. Then I change for the gold toning handpiece in 695. This is the special wavelength for light blue. And it's a matter of time. 2, 3, 4 sessions, I can be successful.
Thank you. Very nice. Melasma always recurs. It's triggered again after sun exposure, especially in Indian skin. What energy is safer for melasma when you're using the PICO laser? And are multiple passes safe?
Yes, I told that, but I remind again. I use the concept of laser toning. That means I use really less amount of power, only 1 joule or 1.2, no more than that. And I pass several times because it's a really less amount of power. The end point is wellness, only that. Not look for frosting, not look for petechia, not look for nothing like this. It takes time. You need to ask to the patient return every 2 weeks and you can see a reduction week per week, and always say that you can reduce the amount of color, but it's impossible to destroy all the color of the melasma.
Very nice. We have time for one last question.
Okay.
For pigmented lesions, and I think they're probably talking here about compound lesions, do you prefer to treat the superficial pigmentation first completely or to treat superficial and deep at the same time?
Oh, very good question and difficult question. I try it in both ways. If you send me in which one I have better experience, I prefer to try the deep pigmentation that is the most difficult for me, and then return and try to remove the shallow ones.
Excellent. Okay, that's an interesting order of treatment. Well, that brings us to the end of the Q&A sessions. Thank you so much indeed, Fabian, for answering these questions so well. And once again, thank you for that first-class presentation. Absolutely marvelous.